Now to a bombshell from Kashmir, separatist leader Asiya Andrabi has links with the Pakistan army. That's according to reports in wire services. Andrabi is reported to have contacted Lashkar-e-Toyba and Jamaat-ul-Dawah chief Hafiz Saeed through an official in the Pakistan army. This officer is said to be a direct relative of Andrabi. An INS report showed that these details have emerged in the investigation against Asiya Andrabi. The National Investigation Agency, the NIA, has been interrogating Asiya Andrabi and a few other separatist leaders over the past few days. The NIA has been given a 10-day custody of these separatists. They are being interrogated in Delhi's Tihar Jail. NIA sources say that the Pakistani official who has mediated these contacts is Andrabi's nephew. In fact, she's said to have many relatives in the Pakistan army, and she may have also used funds leveraged by her relatives both in Dubai and in Saudi Arabia to finance her anti-national activities in India. You may be aware that Asiya Andrabi has a history of anti-India activities. She's the founder of the Dukhtaran-e-Millat, which is a separatist group. This group is part of the All Parties Hurriyat Conference. The Indian government has listed Dukhtaran-e-Millat as a terrorist organization. The group aims to separate Kashmir from India. Since 1992, Asiya Andrabi has been instigating separatism in the valley. She has supported fellow separatists like Basarat Alam. She's hoisted the Pakistani flag in Kashmir. She slaughtered a cow on camera to protest the beef ban in Jammu and Kashmir. In the past, she's been taken into custody by the NIA for allegedly waging war against India. Defense experts say that her arrest is a welcome move.
Asiya Andrabi ne ki wajah se Kashmir ke halaat bahut bigde hain. Inhi ne wahan pe extremism aur militancy ko badhane mein bahut madad ki. अब ये भी साबित हो रहा है कि आईएसआई से इनकी फंडिंग आती थी. मैं समझता हूं कि फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन अभी चल रहा है उनका. हमें कुछ समय वेट करना चाहिए, पूरी डिटेल सामने आ जाएगी. और उनको अगर ऐसा है तो उनको सख्त से सख्त सजा मिलनी चाहिए.
आई थिंक इट हैज बीन अ वेरी एनकरेजिंग ट्रेंड दैट आसिया अंद्राबी हैज बीन टेकन इनटू कस्टडी. All the time, the people in Kashmir know that these are the people who are involved directly and they're working with the Pakistani ISI to destabilize India. For some reason, we have not taken action over the years. Now the government is taking very firm action, and I think the government stand needs to be supported.
This is in fact part of the Modi government's stern action against separatism in the valley. The policy has been called muscular by the opposition parties. PDP chief Mehbooba Mufti recently tweeted that the use of brute force in Kashmir is ridiculous and naive. The National Conference went a step further. 3 days ago, the party branded the arrest of separatist leaders as harassment.
This is harassment and arm twisting. This has been going on. It's not new. These are elements which are a product of the disturbed conditions in the state, of the political status of the state.
Nothing new, says the National Conference, but the case against Asiya Andrabi suggests that she may have been funded by foreigners to sustain her anti-India campaign. Intelligence sources indicate a Lashkar-e-Toyba nexus and a Hawala route to facilitate the flow of funds. The money was then used to sustain the stone pelting against Indian army officials. The reports, if true, are not just shocking. They hint at a deep conspiracy against India and India's sovereignty, one that should be considered a major security threat. And here I want to bring to your notice what the Indian armed forces and the local police face on an everyday basis. This video on your screens has been posted by an officer himself. When the state is polarized to this extent, how can the government take people who sponsor such attacks lightly? How can action against separatists like Asiya Andrabi be termed as harassment? We believe it's important for the government to ensure the participation of Kashmiris to maintain peace in the valley. But that shouldn't mean going soft on those who instigate separatism against India. Asiya Andrabi has sent her own son to study abroad on an Indian passport. But she promoted arson, she supported violence and the shutdown of schools for thousands of other children in the valley. As far as double standards go, Asiya Andrabi beats the regional parties in Jammu and Kashmir by a long shot. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar made his first